My name is Greg Crutsinger, and I was the volunteer data analyst for the public safety drone teams recently on the Carr fire. I also helped on the Tubbs fire in Santa Rosa last October. As part of this digital first responder effort, we use 360 drone panoramics as a rapid tool to visualize fire damage for the city of Reading and for surrounding Shasta County. Now, the teams did an amazing job during the situation. In the first 48 hours, we went from an initial drone flight in the air to maps going public to the residents of the evacuated neighborhoods that we were working in. While I think that 48 hours is fantastic, I think we can do better. 40 hours or 4 hours or even 4 minutes. And I think that we can scale this from Reading to Rio to Riyadh. And here's how. Those of us in the drone industry know that drones are really all about the data. But drone data is overwhelming in these situations. For example, we captured about 100 panos, and each of these panoramics was made of 23 photos. This is about 12 gigs of data to upload to the cloud. For those of you with slow internet at home, you know that this can be near impossible under normal circumstances, let alone an emergency. So during the Carr fire, I thought and racked my brain that there must be a better way, and I think I came up with one. It's a method that's so simple, I overlooked it for 2 fires now, and I think many of us in the drone industry have overlooked it for the past couple of years, but knew all about it. It's cartography with drone telemetry. So let me show you how. Here's a log of a drone flight. You can see that there's lots of messy information about where I flew. But by segmenting the flight log into where I start and stop my video camera on the drone, I now have a very clean line. Essentially, it turns the drone into a three-dimensional highlighter in the sky. Pretend you're out there with the drone team in Reading. So here's what it looked like then, here's what it looks like now while you're on the ground. The team can simply launch a drone, point the camera straight down, and manually fly a trace over critical infrastructure, trying to keep that in the center of the live field of view. You can fly for about 25 minutes per battery, so you can get several linear kilometers of tracing per battery. This could be traces of burn lines where the fire came through. It could be bulldozer lines that were pushed through by the firefighters. It could be evacuation routes that you need immediately. Really, it's any line that you want to draw. Floodwaters, as they rise up, you could fly it repeatedly across time. I can further segment these tracer lines by altitude. Remember, the drone flies in 3D. So when I fly at 100 meters over a road, that means the road is open, it's clear. If I drop down to 50 meters and continue to fly, that means that segment of the road is damaged. Or I can fly different flight patterns. Straight lines over intact power lines, zigzags over damaged power lines. Or I can fly shapes. A square would be for a supply drop. Now remember, in addition to video triggering, we also have photos. When I snap a photo with the drone, a pin can be dropped. It's the pins that I care about, not the photos initially. These pins could be dropped over all the burn homes in a neighborhood, and we would know within a single flight every burn home in a neighborhood just by dropping pins. You get the picture. It's like Morse code in the sky. So you might be asking me, okay, I get it, what's the point? The crucial point here is that all of this information is stored in very small 1 or 2 megabyte text or CSV files. The whole map of an entire burn city could be in a couple of megabytes, the equivalent file size of 1/2 of 1 drone photo and data. The logs can then be rapidly processed into KML files or other types of files that can be exported to Mapbox, ArcGIS, or Google Earth. Essentially, we are turning the flight logs into a standard language that most mapping software that's used by public agencies in the city and town you live in during an emergency would understand. The telemetry can then be synced in real time remotely from any drone flying with a phone or tablet that can be get to just the most basic mobile service. In the drone industry, we are super excited about data, 3D models, machine learning, augmented reality, passenger drones even. But this method, it's not that at all. It's really going back to the basics and recognizing for a good chunk of the world and in emergencies right here in California, life-saving information may come down to a single megabyte text file from a $500 drone flown manually over a disaster zone. So here's the call to action. If you work or know someone in emergency services, if you're a government agency or an NGO, know that this method exists and can be used today and improve upon it. Take it and make it your own.
If you're interested in training, go to scholarfarms.com/fire and enter your name and email and sign up for the newsletter as I release trainings on these different topics.
For the drone software companies, a tiny amount of developer work on existing drone apps that work with low-cost DJI drones will let anyone map a rural village today or your destroyed city tomorrow without internet or imagery if required. But no, this will probably not make you very much money. Finally, let me just say that my heart goes out to those who have lost their homes and lives, both in the Carr fire and the recent fires in Greece. In the next emergency, when I get called out to the scene, I'll be using the same method for data analytics, and I want you to know that you can too. My name is Greg Crutsinger. You can find me at scholarfarms.com. Thank you.